Hello, dear learners. I'm Sruti Sruba, Bharali, working in Krishnakanta Handiko State Open University as an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science. And today we are going to talk about number system. So we have been already familiar with a lot of number systems that are prevalent in our everyday life, like the decimal number system. So let's start with that. So the decimal number system, as we all know, has been made up of 10 digits, that is from 0 to 9. Similarly, there are other number systems also, like binary, octal and hexadecimal number system. So, but let's start our focus on the decimal number system. So here, how do we calculate the weight of a particular number in the decimal number system? The weight of the each digit of a number is dependent on the relative position within the number. For example, if we take a number 6472. So now, we know that it is 6742. But how do we calculate it? For that, we'll take out that the 6402, 6 represents the 6000, 4 represents the 400, 7 represents the 70, and 2 represents the just the digit 2. So now we know for calculating the weight of each digit, it depends on the relative position. And the position, it starts from the left hand side. So now the position of the digit 2 is in the units place. So for this, we'll calculate the weight by 2 into 10 to the power 0. Now we have taken 10 since the base of this decimal number system is 10. That is the total of all the unique digits that are present in a particular number system. Similarly, the weight for the second digit will be 7 into 10 to the power 1. The weight of the third digit will be 4 into 10 to the power 2, and the weight of the fourth digit will be 6 into 10 to the power 3. And now if we want to calculate the total weight of this number, we'll calculate the sum of all of these digits and we'll get a total of 6472. So if we calculate a particular formula using this derivation, we'll get that it is the nth digit multiplied by the base to the power of n minus 1. So this works not only for the decimal number system, this also works for the binary and the other number systems. So now let's move on to the binary number system. In the binary number system, we have only two digits, that are 0 and 1. Now, since there are only two digits and we can represent 2 in mathematics as bi, so from there comes the name binary. So here also there are only two digits 0 and 1, and if we take a particular number, binary number, say for example 10110, then in this case the weight can be calculated by using the earlier formula. That is, the last digit, that is 0, will have a weight of 0 into 2 to the power 0. The next number 1 into 2 to the power 1, again 1 into 2 to the power 2, again 0 into 2 to the power 3, and then 1 into 2 to the power 4. Now, which will give us the decimal equivalent of this binary number, which is 22. Now, likewise, we can calculate the weight of other binary numbers also. Now, next, look at this slide where we have the decimal number and its equivalent binary number. So here we can see that 0 is represented as 0 in binary number system also. 1 is represented as 1, but now for the value of 2, it is represented as 10. Again, 3 is represented as 11. Again, now 4 will be represented by 1 and then followed by 2 zeros. The next number again will be represented as 101, that is the decimal number 5. Similarly, we can see the equivalent binary numbers for the decimal number from 0 to 15. Now, let's look at another number system, that is the octal number system. Now, the octal number system has 8 digits starting from 0 till 7, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And the base is the number of digits that are in the system, and so it will be 8. So now, how do we represent a decimal 9 or a decimal 10 in the octal number system? First of all, for 8, it will be represented as 1 and 0. For 9, it will be represented as 1, 1. Again, for 10, it will be represented as 1 and 2. Now, since 8 can be represented as 2 to the power of 3, so an octal number can be easily represented by a group of 3 binary digits. For example, 3 can be represented as 011, 4 can be represented as 100. Now, let us look at this slide. Here we can see that the decimal number is given and the octal number is given, and their binary coded octal number has also been given. Here we can see that till 7 the octal number remains from 0 to 7, but after that for the decimal number 8 it has been represented as 1 and again will start from a 0. Similarly, for the decimal number 9 we have a 1 and then the next number after 0 is 1, so it will be 2 ones. Similarly, for 10, it can be represented as 1 and then followed by the next number, that is 2. Similarly, if you have to represent decimal 11 in the octal number system, it will be 1 followed by the next number, that is 3. Similarly, if we now look at the binary coded octal numbers, we can see each individual octal number has been represented by its binary form. That is, for 0 in the binary coded octal number, if it is going to be represented by 3 digits, so 3 binary digits, so it will be 000. Again, 1, it will be 001. Similarly, for 7, we can see it is 111. Likewise, for the octal number 10, it will be represented, 1 will be represented separately by 3 digits, again 0 will be represented separately by 3 digits. So it will be 001 and 000. Similarly, for the octal number 11, it will be represented as 001, 001. Likewise, it will be true for all the other octal numbers. Now, let's look at the other number system, that is the decimal number system. Now, in the hexadecimal number system, there are 16 numbers, and so it has a base of 16, and the 16 numbers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, followed by, we are using symbols now, A, B, C, D, E, F. So now, since 16 can be represented as 2 to the power 4, so again this hexadecimal can be used to represent using a group of binary bits, that is a group of 4 binary bits. For example, if we have to represent 5 using binary bits, it is going to be represented as 0101. Now, let us look at this slide where we have the decimal numbers, their hexadecimal equivalent and their binary coded hexadecimal number. So here we can see from 0 to 9, the hexadecimal numbers are also 0 to 9. But when we need to represent the decimal number 10, then the hexadecimal number will be A. Similarly, for 11, it goes to B, then C, D, E, F. This continues till F. So the next number, if we have to represent, then it will be F, 0. Similarly, we can see that the binary coded hexadecimal numbers are represented by 4 binary digits. So the binary equivalent of 0 is 000, the binary equivalent of 9 is 1001. Similarly, for binary equivalent of F is 1111. So till now we have seen that these are the 4 number systems that are mostly used in the computer. Now next, let us see, look at certain conversions of the binary systems, that is from binary to decimal, decimal to binary, binary to octal, and all this type of conversions. Now, let us look at the number system conversions. So, first of all, we'll try to convert the binary number into a decimal number. So, for this, we first mark the bit positions and then we give the weight of each bit of the number depending on its position. Then we sum the all of the weights of the bits, and which will give us the equivalent number. So, let us look at an example first. So, here, we are trying to convert the binary number 110100 to its equivalent decimal number. So here, first of all, what we'll do is we'll break up each of these bits and we'll add its weight to each of the particular numbers. So now let us look at this example where we're trying to convert this binary number to its decimal equivalent. So if we need to express this, we'll calculate the weights. For example, this 0, it is in the units place, so we'll multiply this 0 with 2 to the power 0. Now this is in 1's place, so we'll multiply this 0 with 2 to the power 1. Similarly, the 1 will be multiplied with 2 to the power 2, the 0 will be multiplied by 2 to the power 3, the 1 again will be multiplied by 2 to the power 4, and this 2 to the power 5. Now, when we calculate the sum of these, now these zeros will be equivalent to 0. So we'll consider only the 1's here. So we'll get 1 into 2 to the power 5 plus 1 into 2 to the power 4
plus 1 into 2 to the power 2. So if we calculate it, we'll get 32 plus 16 plus 4, which will give us a 52. That is the decimal equivalent of this binary number. Now, next, let us look at the binary to decimal conversion again, but with something that is a fraction. That is, it will have a decimal part.
Binary to decimal conversions.
So now, this is our example. The binary number is this. Now, again, for this part, we know how to calculate this decimal equivalent. So here, we'll multiply this one with its weight, that is 2 to the power 0. Again, this one to 2 to the power 1. Here, the 0 with 2 to the power 2. Again, 1 with 2 to the power 3, 1 with 2 to the power 4, and again, the last one is 2 to the power 5. So, we already know this part from the last example. So, now for this part, the decimal part, we'll multiply the first one with 2 to the power minus 1, then the 0 with 2 to the power minus 2, and 1 with its 2 to the power minus 3. That is, the weights are in the negative form here. Now, if we calculate it, if we sum it up, then it will be 32. Plus 16 plus 8 plus 0 plus 2 plus 1, and again the decimal part, that is, this will be 0.5, this will be 0, and again this will be 0.125. now if we sum it up, we'll get 59.625, which is the decimal equivalent of this binary number.
Decimal to binary conversions.
So learners, now we'll see how to convert a decimal number to its binary equivalent. So this is a fraction which I have taken. So first we'll try to convert this 12 to its binary equivalent, and then we'll look at the 0.75 part. So for 12, what we do is we repeatedly divide this number by 2. Why 2? Because 2 is the base of the binary number, and since we are trying to convert it to a binary number, so we'll divide the number with 2. Now till when do we need to divide? Till we get a remainder which is not further divisible. Okay, so now 2, if we divide 12 by 2, we'll get 6, and the remainder will be 0. We need to keep track of these remainders. Again, 6, again if we divide by 2, we get 3. Again, 3 if we divide by 2, we get 1. Now from 1 here, we are not going to be able to divide it any further. So this 1, we need to add it as the MSB of the remainder. That is the most significant bit of the remainder. So now, this will calculate it in this way. That is, the binary number 12 will be represented now as 1100. That is, here we can see 12 can be represented as 1100. That is, we will go from the downward to the upward. Next, now let us look at this 0.75 part. So for this, what we'll do, now we'll multiply this 0.75 by 2. So here we can see 0.75 we have multiplied by 2. So what we have got is 1.50. Now this 1 will keep it as a remainder part. So now again this 0.50 will be multiplied by 2. So next time we'll get 1.00. Now as soon as we get 00 here, or till a particular number of decimal places, whichever you choose, then we can stop this calculation. Since we have got 00 here, in the second attempt itself, we'll stop our calculation here. So now, for getting the decimal equivalent of 0.75, we'll join the bits in the downward form, that is 1 1. So in this way, 0.75 can be represented as 0.11 in its binary equivalent. Now if we combine these two numbers, we'll get 12.75 is equivalent to 1100.11 in its binary equivalent.
Octal to decimal conversions.
Okay learners, so now let us look at octal to decimal conversion. So now here we have taken an octal number 153. So to convert it to its decimal equivalent, what we'll do is we'll multiply it every digit with its weighted sum. So now 3 will be multiplied with 8 to the power of 0. Now why 8? Because the base of the octal number system is 8, since there are 8 unique digits in it. Next, again, 5 will be multiplied by 8 to the power 1, and this 1 will be multiplied by 8 to the power 2. So we'll get the equivalent 64, 40 and 3. So we'll sum it up and we get 107. So the equivalent of this octal number is 10 in its decimal form. Now let us look at another octal number which has a fraction in it. So now this 123 part can be easily done, followed by the above procedure. we'll multiply 3 with 8 to the power 0, 2 with 8 to the power 1, and 1 with 8 to the power 2. Now, for this 0.21 part, what we'll do? Likewise, we did in the binary number system earlier, we'll multiply this 2 with 8 to the power minus 1. And again, this 1 with 8 to the power minus 2. So now, when we sum it up, what we get is 64 plus 16 plus 3 plus the decimal part 0.25 plus 0.156. That is, we get 83.2656. That is, the decimal equivalent of 123.21 is this.
Octal to binary and binary to octal conversions.
So now let us look at octal to binary and then binary to octal conversion. So octal to binary conversion is very simple. We have this octal number and we'll represent each of the digits of this octal number by its equivalent binary form. So now, for example, we have taken the number 124.73. So now 4 has been represented by its binary equivalent 100, 2 by its binary equivalent 010, 1 by its binary equivalent 001, 7 by its binary equivalent 111, and 3 by its binary equivalent 011. So now when we club it, we get the binary equivalent of a particular octal number. Now again, let us look at binary to octal conversion. So here we have a binary number and we are going to convert it into octal. So for this, we need to make a group of 3 bits. So starting from the decimal point here, we'll make a group of 3. So it will be 110 and again 011, and then last one, it will be remain single. Again, a group of 3 for the decimal part as well. We'll start from here, 111, and again this one will be left alone. So here we have to remember that for making a group for the number part, we'll start in this way, and for making a group here in the fraction part, we'll go to the this time. Now this equivalent is 1, this the equivalent of this octal number is 7, the equivalent of this is 3, the equivalent of 110 is 6, and equivalent of 1 is 1. So we'll get a number 163.71.
hexadecimal to decimal and decimal to hexadecimal conversions.
So learners, now we'll convert hexadecimal number to its decimal equivalent. So for this, we have taken this example 53A.0B4. So now we know the base of a hexadecimal number is 16. So we'll multiply each of these digits with 16, with its corresponding weight. So now 5, it is in the third decimal place. So it will be 16 to the power of 2. 3 will be 3 into 16 to the power of 1. Now A, it is in unit place, so the will be 16 to the power of 0. So now here A has been replaced by 10 because the decimal equivalent of A is 10. Again, 0 into, since this is a decimal part, so this will be 0 into 16 to the power minus 1. Again, B into 16 to the power minus 2. Now again, B has been converted to its decimal equivalent, that is 11. Now last 4 into 16 to the power minus 3. So now when we calculate the sum of all these numbers, we get 1338 into 40439. That is its decimal equivalent. Now let us again look at decimal to hexadecimal conversion. Now for this, we have taken a number 1234. That is a decimal number. Now we need to convert it to a hexadecimal number. Now similar to decimal to binary conversion, where we divided the decimal number by 2, again in octal, where we converted divided the decimal number by 8. So here, since the base is 16, we'll divide the decimal number by 16. So here, if we divide 1234 by 16, we get a quotient of 77 and a remainder of 2, where this is the decimal form and this is the hexadecimal form. So 2 in its hexadecimal form is also represented as 2. Now again, 77, it is again divided by 16, so we get a remainder of 4 here, when here we get 13. So now this 13 in the hexadecimal form, it is again represented as D. So now this 4, since it cannot be divided by any further, this is added as the MSP, that is the most significant bit of this part. So now this 4 will again be taken as 4 in the hexadecimal system. So now we read the numbers from down to top. So it will be 4d2. So 1234 in its decimal form, it is represented as 4d2 in its hexadecimal form.
Hexadecimal to binary conversions.
So learners, the last number system conversion that we are going to do now is hexadecimal to binary. So here we can see that we have taken a hexadecimal number 12A.D3. So now we are going to convert this number to its binary equivalent form. So for that we have taken this number 12A.D3. So we are going to convert each of this digits into its equivalent binary form. So 1 will be converted to its binary form, again 2 is converted, again A is separately converted, after the point also D is converted, and again 3 is converted. So now the decimal, the binary equivalent of 1 is 0001, for 2 it's 0010. We have taken a group of 4 bits here because the base of hexadecimal number is 16, and 16 can be represented as 2 to the power 4. So we need to use a group of 4 bits here. So again, A is 1010, D is 1101, and 3 is 0011. So when we club it together, we get the equivalent binary representation for this hexadecimal number.
So learners, today in this video, we have learned about the number system, the different types of number system, that is the binary number system, the decimal number system, the octal number system, and the hexadecimal number system. We have also learned how to convert a number from a particular number system to another number system. For example, from a binary number system to its equivalent octal, decimal, or hexadecimal number system. In the next video, we'll learn about the binary arithmetic operations, that is how to do addition, multiplication, subtraction, and division using binary digits. Thank you.